That'd be good.
Let's bring a little wind out there here. Make you get there. That ain't gonna happen.
Excited for this. I have a couple announcements first. This play will be an interactive play. So if everybody looks at their program, you'll notice there's three songs on there. Silent Night's the first one, Away in the Manger second, and The First Noel is the third. You guys will join in singing those songs once you hear Lisa strum the guitar. Okay? The other announcement is right after this, there's the silent auction in the fellowship hall, and everybody's welcome to join us. If anybody has not been to a silent auction before, basically what it is there's a bunch of stuff laid out on the tables, and there's a piece of paper. If you want to bid on something, put your name in the bid, and that will run till 8 o'clock, and promptly at 8 o'clock, we will announce who the winner is, and you'll be able to take the items home with you tonight. And there's also going to be holiday treats and warm drinks with that, too. So everybody come for that. And let me see. I think that's it. And after Haywood has said a prayer, we will begin the program.
Ma'am?
Lord, we remember tonight that Jesus said, "Suffer the little children to come unto me." And that is a powerful, powerful invitation. It tells us that the children are at the heart of the gospel. And so we thank you that we're gathered tonight and we're gathered in good fellowship and how precious children are to us. And we thank you for the opportunity that we are able to introduce them and to lead them in the way that we are certain is the right way and the best way, and that is in Jesus Christ, in His church. So bless us tonight. Be with us and give us that blessing that we know we'll get because children are involved in how you do love them. Amen.
Christmas story is read from the Gospel of Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 20. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went out from the town of Nazareth to Galilee, to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who is pledged to be married to him, and he was expecting a child. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you.
living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them. And the glory of the Lord shone around them, but they were terribly afraid. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy. That will be for all the people today in the town of David. A Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. That will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who is lying in a manger. Shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, for just as they had been told.
Thank you.
say thank you to all the parents and everybody who has helped with this sound, decorating, setup. I just want to thank everybody so much. And you guys can all join us now for the silent auction in the fellowship hall.
You should have them stay up there and get